upper caste, lower caste, all these caste systems. They are Brahmins, they are the uppermost. They are the Kshatriyas, they are lower than the Brahmins. They are the Baniyas, they are the number three. After the Kshatriyas, they are lower than the Kshatriyas. And they are the Shudras, they are the lowest, downtrodden. Buddha said this division, not man, God made, it is a man made. God has never given any instruction in any holy of his books to divide a society. But God has said one thing. The basic purpose of all the religion is to safeguard the interest and promote the unity of the human race and to foster the spirit of love and fellowship amongst men. To dear children, Buddha taught us caste system was created for a society very much different from that of today. They lost its relevance and do not follow the caste system. Consider everybody as equal so that society may remain united. For the unity's sake, there should be no caste system in the society. 2000 years ago, again, through Jesus Christ, a message was sent. Enlightenment came to Jesus Christ. And he was being put to cross. People were putting nails in his body through a thick hammer. They were killing him. And he was praying, God, oh God, pardon them, those who are killing me, because they are ignorant. They are not criminals. But they have not been taught about the teachings of God. They have never studied the teachings of God. They are ignorant. Dear children, this is ignorance if we do not know the teachings of God. Dear children, this is the message of Jesus Christ. Love thy neighbor. The whole humanity I have created, they are my neighbor. They are also neighbor to you. So that was the teaching of unity of Jesus Christ. Then 1400 years ago, Muhammad came to this earth. And the first verse that God has given to Muhammad was, Khuda is Rabbul Alameen. He is the God of the entire humanity. The whole earth has been created by one God. So this is the message of Muhammad, the message of God, Allah, which came through Muhammad. Muhammad got the message through a farishta for 23 long years. An angel, a representative of God, was coming from God and giving the teachings to Muhammad. And Muhammad was illiterate, he could not write. So there were some people who knew that they were writing the teachings, Muhammad was telling them, this is the message has come from God, this is the teaching has come from God. That is called ayat, Quran ki ayate. And they were writing on the palm leaves, tar ki pattiyon pe likh lete the, or on the backbone of the ships. Bhede bahut hoti thi, to sukhi khale padi milti thi, unhi pe likh lete the. And they were collected, and that became Holy Quran. So Holy Quran is the words from God, from Allah. We can call him God, we can call him Allah, we can call him Bhagwan, we can call him Ishwar, we can call him thousands of names here in every language, in German, French, Russian, Spanish. In every language of the world, there is a name given to it. Like the water, somebody says it's water, somebody says it's Pani, somebody says it's Jal, somebody says it's Aab. There are thousands and thousands of names. In every language there is a name given to water. Likewise, the message came, Khuda is Rabbul Alameen, he is the Rabb of the whole humanity, he is the creator, Allah is the creator of the whole humanity. They are all children of one God. We have to love each other. We are like brothers and sisters. So that was the message of Quran Sharif. Then it came 1400 years ago. Then again, 550 years ago, Guru Granth Sahib came to the heart of Nanak. It says, Abba Lallah Noor Paya, Kudrat ke sab bande, aur ek noor te sab jag upja, kaun bhale kaun mande. Aur Nanak naam chardi kala, kab jab tere bhane sarvat da bhala. Nanak ka naam is the name by which you can reach to God. But when you do good to the whole of humanity, only then the world is ek noor te sab jag upja. The whole humanity has been born from one God. And you love the whole humanity. If you sacrifice for the whole humanity, then only you can reach to God. The dear children, this is the message of Nanak. He also says, whole humanity. Sacrifice for the whole humanity. So that is the message. And then again, unite yourself. Again, 200 years ago, message came from God to Baha'u'llah. His picture is not available. So he put the picture of his son, Abdul Baha. The message was unity of hearts. Oh my God, unite the hearts of thy servants and reveal to them the great purpose. May they follow thy commandments and abide in thy law. Help them, O God, in their endeavor and grant them strength to serve thee. O God, lead them not themselves, but guide their steps by the light of thy knowledge and clear their hearts by thy love. Verily, thou art the helper and the Lord. एक कर दे हृदय अपने सेवकों के हे प्रभु और निज महान उद्देश्य उन पर कर प्रकट मेरे विभो. So these are the teachings. All the teachings have come from one God. The basic purpose of all the religion is to safeguard the interest and promote the unity of the human race. All the religions teach us unity of the human race and to foster the spirit of love and fellowship amongst them. They have all come, you give me aaye. Ramayana kehti hai, ki jab jab hoya, dharma ki hani, aur baadhi asura adham abhimani. To tab tab prabhu, ek hi prabhu hai. Dhari vivid sharira, hare kripani visarjana pira. To ek hi parmatma, you give me aata hai. प्रोग्रेसिव रिवोल्यूशन. परमात्मा अपने शब्दों को प्रोग्रेसिवली रिवील करता है. प्रोग्रेसिव रिवोल्यूशन इज रिलीजियस ट्रूथ इज रिवील्ड बाय गॉड प्रोग्रेसिवली एंड साइक्लिकली ओवर ए टाइम थ्रू सीरीज ऑफ डिवाइन टीचर्स एंड द टीचिंग्स आर टेलर्ड टू सूट द नीड्स ऑफ डिफरेंट एजेस एंड प्लेसेस ऑफ देयर अपीयरेंस. तो प्यारे बच्चों, ये हर धर्म जो आए हैं ये युग युग में आए हैं, एक परमात्मा से आए हैं. और तीसरी चीज है, ऑल द रिवील्ड बुक्स ऑफ गॉड आर अनरिंग. जितनी भी रिवील्ड बुक्स आई है, गीता, त्रिपिटक, बाइबल, कुरान, गुरु ग्रंथ साहब, किताब एक देश किताब जागरिता, दे आर ऑल अनरिंग. देर इज नो मिस्टेक इन इट. दे आर ऑल अनरिंग, नो मिस्टेक. In all these holy books, there is no mistake. All the revealed books of God are unerring and collected wisdom. God has collected all the wisdom of all the ages since God created this universe. All the wisdom is enshrined into the holy books. All the revealed books of God are unerring and collected wisdom, collected by God for the benefit of man. Collected wisdom that are sent by one God as required from age to age to open the mental locks of mankind and to cure the maladies of the age. And dear children, all the wisdom of all the ages since God created this universe, all the wisdom is enshrined into the holy books. All the revealed books of God are unerring and collected wisdom, collected by God for the benefit of man. Collected wisdom that are sent by one God as required from age to age to open the mental locks of mankind and to cure the maladies of the age. And dear children, Nelson Mandela said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Paulo Freire says, education does not change the world. Education changes the people. People change the world. Gandhiji said, if we are to teach the real peace in this world, if we are to carry on a real war against war, we shall have to begin with the children. There are three classrooms of a child. Classroom number one is the home. Classroom number two is the school. Classroom number three is the society. In the home, you will find that the family that prays together stays together. You will find mother, father, brother and sister, they are all praying together. And in this house, you will find Gita, you will find Quran, you will find Bible, Guru Granth Sahib. This house is blessed by God and by all the manifestations of God, all the divine educators. This should be the house like. You should all create a house like this. And classroom number two for a child is its secondary source of empowerment, is the school. What is a school? A school is a lighthouse of society. To provide meaningful education, spiritual direction, guidance and leadership to students, their parents and the society in general. Let us make every child both good and smart. And if you are both good and smart, you will become a gift of God to mankind. You will become a pride of human race and you will become a potential light of the world. You need to know knowledge, wisdom, spiritual perception, eloquent speech, universal values, global understanding, service to the world and excellence in all things. Classroom number three is the society. In society we must teach now that God is one, all the books have come from one God. All these teachers, the divine teachers, all these divine gurus, we should tell them that God is one, religion is one, man is one. We should also teach them that don't show how different you are. Show to the people that we are all one. We are all children of one God. And then, it is a bulb here. If the bulb is connected to the powerhouse, then light will come to the bulb. But if this is disconnected from the powerhouse, there is no light in the bulb, there is darkness in the bulb. If a child is connected to God, the kingdom of God, where from all the holy books have come, he will become rational, he will become wise, he will become godly, he will become total quality person, he will become good, he will become total quality person, TQP, he will become total quality manager, TQM, like a divine angel. A good human being is a blessing for human society. And if this wire is broken from the entire kingdom of God, the child may become irrational, unwise, ungodly, bad, totally misguided person, totally misguided person, totally misguided manager, like an animal. A bad human being is a curse for human society, totally unworthy and unacceptable to society. Here is a child who says, I am a material being, I am a human being, I am a divine being. I will be good in my studies, I will be a good human being. One day I will unite the world and I will love God and learn His teachings. These are all good qualities that a child has. A child is the hope and the promise of the future. You are the hope and the promise of the future. If one child is made a total quality person, he can change the world and unite it. So dear children, you can unite the world. Here is a wire. You connect it to the powerhouse, and if you do not connect it, you can take a picture of it. If you remove the plastic, still you can take the picture, but you cannot know whether there is energy or not. How will you know? If you connect it to the powerhouse, you cannot know there is energy. How will you know? You know, the fan starts, you can know, yes, this wire is connected to the powerhouse. If you put it with the bulb, you can know, yes, this wire is connected to the powerhouse. You can keep a bigger bulb. If the bulb is lighted, then you can say, yes, this is connected to the powerhouse. Likewise, you can take a picture of man. You cannot know whether this man is connected to God or not. If you remove this skin and you take the picture of the bones and his flesh, still you will not be able to know whether you are connected to God or not. It is only through your deeds, your acts, that you will be known you are connected to God or not. So dear children, we have to learn to connect to our God. If we connect it now, a day will come when you will be the greatest man on earth. So connect yourself to God, and that is the end of it. Vishwa hame deta hai sab kuch, hum bhi to kuch dena seekhe. Vishwa hame deta hai sab kuch, hum bhi to kuch dena seekhe.
We raise the banner of our school and see it flying high. We raise together all our voices till they reach the sky. CMS is the place to be. CMS is for you.
इस दुनिया में अरबों की संख्या में लोग आते हैं और फिर चले जाते हैं, परंतु संसार में कुछ लोग ऐसे भी हैं जिनकी सोच, जिनकी बातें, जिनके कार्य और जिनका जीवन संपूर्ण विश्व की एकता और विश्व शांति जैसे व्यापक उद्देश्य हेतु बलिदान एवं समर्पण की महान गाथा हैं। सौभाग्य से विश्व में एक ऐसा बिरला और अनोखा व्यक्ति है जिसे लोग डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी के नाम से जानते और पहचानते हैं। एक ऐसा व्यक्ति जो वर्ष 1959 से एक अनोखे मिशन के लिए दिन भर कार्य करने के अलावा सोते वक्त भी चिंतन करता रहता है और इस मिशन की सफलता के लिए सदैव समर्पित रहता है। जी हाँ, डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी का एकमात्र मिशन है विश्व एकता के द्वारा विश्व में शांति स्थापित करना। इसी मिशन को ध्यान में रखते हुए डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी ने अति सीमित साधनों, शक्तिशाली दृष्टिकोण और अनेक आशाओं के साथ सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल की स्थापना की। उद्देश्य था कि एक दिन सभी विद्यार्थीगण सीएमएस के द्वार और प्रांगण से गुजरते हुए विश्व एकता और विश्व शांति के आदर्शों को जन जन तक पहुंचाएंगे। डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी एक सुप्रसिद्ध भारतीय शिक्षाविद और विश्व के सबसे बड़े स्कूल सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल के संस्थापक प्रबंधक हैं। सीएमएस यानी सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल विश्व का सबसे बड़ा प्राइवेट स्कूल है और गिनीज बुक ऑफ वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड्स में सीएमएस का नाम दर्ज है। वर्तमान में तकरीबन 55,000 छात्र छात्राएं सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल में अध्ययन कर रहे हैं। सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल उत्तर प्रदेश की राजधानी लखनऊ में स्थित है। सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल के 18 कैंपस हैं जो कि लखनऊ शहर के विभिन्न भागों में शिक्षा प्रदान कर रहे हैं। सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल को वर्ष 2002 में शिक्षा के द्वारा शांति का प्रचार और प्रसार करने के लिए संयुक्त राष्ट्र के यूनेस्को प्राइज फॉर पीस एजुकेशन से सम्मानित किया जा चुका है। सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल इस प्रतिष्ठित शांति पुरस्कार को प्राप्त करने वाला समूचे विश्व और भारत का प्रथम विद्यालय है। प्रत्येक रविवार को प्रातः 10 बजे से 11 बजे तक सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल के गोमती नगर प्रथम कैंपस में विश्व एकता सत्संग का आयोजन किया जाता है। इस सत्संग में सभी वर्ग और समुदाय के लोग सपरिवार सादर आमंत्रित होते हैं। डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी पूर्व में लखनऊ विश्वविद्यालय छात्र संघ के अध्यक्ष रह चुके हैं। डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी अतीत में उत्तर प्रदेश के अलीगढ़ जिले के सिकंदरा राव निर्वाचन क्षेत्र से भारी मतों से विजय प्राप्त कर उत्तर प्रदेश विधानसभा के निर्वाचित सदस्य रहे हैं। डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी को उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार द्वारा यश भारती सम्मान से भी अलंकृत किया जा चुका है। डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी को तमाम अंतर्राष्ट्रीय, राष्ट्रीय और राजकीय पुरस्कारों और सम्मानों से नवाजा जा चुका है। पिछले 5 दशकों से भी अधिक समय में डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी ने एक विश्व शांति कार्यकर्ता और विश्व शांति दूत के रूप में अनेक देशों और प्रदेशों की यात्रा की तथा उन सभी स्थानों पर अपने विचारों और संदेशों से लोगों को जागरूक किया है। संयुक्त राज्य अमेरिका के जॉर्जिया नगर की कुंजी, फिलीपींस के प्रतिष्ठित गुइसी शांति पुरस्कार, जर्मनी का प्रतिष्ठित न्यूक्लियर फ्री फ्यूचर स्पेशल अचीवमेंट अवार्ड और यूएसए का चेंज मेकर्स इनोवेशन अवार्ड, ये कुछ ऐसे सम्मान हैं जो कि सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल ने डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी के सफल मार्गदर्शन में प्राप्त किए हैं। डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी को वर्ष 2009 में रूस के बशकीर स्टेट पेडागॉजिकल यूनिवर्सिटी द्वारा शिक्षा में मानद डॉक्टरेट की उपाधि प्रदान की गई। इसके अलावा डॉक्टर गांधी को संसार के विभिन्न देशों के विश्वविद्यालयों ने अनेक मानक उपाधियां प्रदान की हैं। डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी का मानना है कि मानवता के अस्तित्व के लिए एक विश्व न्यायपालिका का सृजन एक अंतिम और एकमात्र उपाय है और इसीलिए विश्व के 2.5 अरब बच्चों तथा जन्म लेने वाली भावी पीढ़ियों के उज्जवल एवं सुरक्षित भविष्य के लिए उनके मार्गदर्शन में सीएमएस के 55,000 विद्यार्थी विश्व एकता और विश्व शांति के लिए निरंतर प्रयासरत हैं। सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल द्वारा 18वां विश्व न्यायतंत्र शिखर समारोह तथा विश्व के मुख्य न्यायाधीशों का अंतर्राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन दिनांक 8 से 14 नवंबर 2017 के दौरान कानपुर रोड शाखा के विश्व एकता सम्मेलन केंद्र में आयोजित किया जा रहा है। डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी के मार्गदर्शन में सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल द्वारा चलाए जा रहे विश्व एकता और विश्व शांति अभियान का मुख्य आकर्षण है वर्ष 2001 से निरंतर आयोजित एक अत्यंत सफल विश्व न्यायतंत्र शिखर समारोह तथा विश्व के मुख्य न्यायाधीशों का अंतर्राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन, जिसमें अब तक दुनिया के 126 देशों के 1000 से भी अधिक माननीय न्यायाधीश और राज्यों और गणराज्यों के माननीय प्रमुख भाग लेते आ रहे हैं।
शिक्षात्मक सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम एवं चिंतन हेतु विश्व एकता सत्संग में आप सभी सपरिवार सादर आमंत्रित हैं।